Well, again, I see that it's a consequence of continual agitation by, I would say, a minority of the left, the radical left in particular, and those are people who are Marxist / neo-Marxist in their fundamental ideological orientation and have joined that in an unholy union with the worst of French postmodernism. And they push it forward ideological certainty. And the thing that's really distressing about that is that if you know anything about the history of oppressed people, let's say, much as I hate to engage in that particular form of dialogue under the current conditions, it's pretty obvious that it's freedom of speech is a freedom that's particularly important for people who don't have anything else. Right? It's, if you're supporting freedom of speech, you're not supporting the status quo. I mean, just think about it. Let's use the logic of the radical leftists and assume that society is a tyrannical hierarchy and the people at the top have the upper hand in everything, including access to communication. These people are not your friends. You see, you know, and mark my words, that's the sounds of the barbarians pounding at the gates. Right. Yeah, that's, I'll tell you again too, that use of inchoate, what would you call it? Inchoate sensation is the best formulation of their argument. And there's not much difference between knocking on the doors and knocking on you. So keep that in mind. It's not amusing. There's nothing to it. There's nothing for it. The thing that's also quite appalling is that there's no evidence whatsoever that the people who are conducting these protests know what it is that they're protesting against. You know, I was in the midst of a discussion attempting to make the case that it's freedom of speech that is what people who have nothing still have, right? So if you look at the tyrannical structure of our society, let's say the people at the top have access to means of communication. Everyone knows that. It's the people at the bottom who have the right to say what they think, however badly they say it, that enables them to get a toehold into the system and to make their suffering known. That's what freedom of speech is for. And so, like, what's the protest against that? And I'll tell you, you know, that the radical neo-Marxist types, they speak the language of power, and that's what they're speaking right now. And if you want to live in a world where everyone speaks the language of power, then just let them do what they're doing and see what happens. I wouldn't recommend it. It's not a pretty road. And you're all in a position, you're all in a situation in your life now where you have to make decisions about these sorts of things. Like, is this the sort of institution that you want this to be?